All right, welcome. I'm Tavleen and I am the Chief of Marketing at excelplugins.com, and where we're talking about sales triggers, which is an excelplugins.com product. And if you want more information, feel free to head out to excelplugins.com/WooCommerce sales triggers. I would suggest that you watch this video first. All right, so in this video, we're talking about something really interesting. It's the sales activity insights trigger. So it's one of the 7 sales triggers that allows you to increase your conversions on your WooCommerce store. Each of these triggers is actually backed by shopper psychology. And if you haven't watched, if this is the first video that you're watching on sales triggers, I would request you to watch the others, which are on the YouTube channel, because you will find out how each of the sales triggers is actually backed by a shopper psychology. So it's no fluff at all. All right, so with that context set, let's move on. And let me ask you a quick question. Are you more likely to go to this restaurant or this restaurant? Well, if you're like most people, I am sure that your answer is this one, the one that you can see on the screen right now. Why? Well, because there are more people here, and whereas this one is completely empty, right? So while this restaurant gives a sense that it's not really doing well, there are not many people coming over, so it probably wouldn't be good, right? Whereas this one gives a sense that since it's busy and it attracts crowd, it means that it is good. And we also go a step further to deduce that this visual signal also means that their food is good, right? We haven't tasted the food, but we can see a lot of people sitting here, they're having a good chat, and they seem to be enjoying, so we deduce that the food must be good too, right? Whereas in this case, we see no one sitting here and it's empty, right? And so we don't want to be the first ones to go there, and we don't want to take the risk, right? Because obviously, what if it's not right? But here, the wisdom of crowd works in its favor. You know, so many people can't be wrong. Right, so that is why you assume that it is rather a good restaurant, and it is actually because it's serving so many people and the food also is good, right? This is also called in psychology, this is also called halo effect, right? So by definition, halo effect is a cognitive bias, which is an observer's overall impression of a person, company, or brand or product influences the observer's feelings and thoughts about that entity's character or properties, right? So I'm going to actually now show you how you can use this insight in your favor, this insight about social proof and this insight about halo effect, right? So if you're a WooCommerce store owner, I will show you how you can configure something like this on your WooCommerce product page. So it says 3 orders in the last 30 days, or this little snippet about the names of the people and the cities from where they have bought it. Right now, these are little snippets of information which actually show the recent sales activity on your store. It helps convince people that your store is actually not an empty store and that people are buying that particular product, and it takes care of their last minute objections and fears and doubts. It just arrests them and lets people know that others are also investing in this product. Right now, this is not a typed information, right? It is a very authentic information which is coming from your store's backend. You can always you can edit the text, so you can edit the text here. What it is doing is that it allows you to choose. So sales triggers actually allows you to choose the duration. So here's, like in this case, it's 30 days. You could bring it down to 15 days if it's a fast selling item. You could take it up to a year. You could take it up to 3-6 months, right? And you could just say that let's say 10 orders in 10 orders recently, or 10 orders in the last 6 months, right? So you have the option to edit all of that, right? Also here, it's picking up names again from your store's backend, right? While you're always welcome to edit it, you're always welcome to change it, but it closely communicates with your store's actual sales data to show these snippets on the product page, right? So now I'm going to take you behind the scenes and I'll show you how this is done.
So let me take you to the backend and show it. So here we have the sales activity trigger. Within that, we have two options, which is sales count and sales snippet. I will cover both of these, but first let me cover the sales count option, right? So here, as you can notice, you have, it asks you date limit. So date limit, what that basically means is that in what duration you would like your sales to be displayed. So if you say, let's say 3 days or 15 days or 30 days, you can choose whatever number you want. It's going to get the data. It's going to fetch the data from your store backend and show that data here. So here are two merge tags. One is order count. The other is sold item count. So order count is how many orders have been placed. So 7 orders in the last 30 days, right? And the sold item count is, so let's say one order constituted of 2 sales, or maybe so one order was 2 sales, the other order was 3 sales. So then it's going to show the number of items that have been sold, right? So it's going to show that number over here. Also, what is interesting is that you can tell it to hide if the number of orders is less than, and you can choose the number here, right? So what you're basically telling it is that, look, if the number of items sold in the past 30 days is actually less than 3 or 4 or 5, then do not display this sales trigger. Do not activate it on that product, right? So that is what you are letting it know. And now you have all these options of changing the background color, the border color, the text color, and the font size. So as you can notice right now, we have white as the background color, and we have a little gray border outline, and we are showing the text in black color, right? And the font size is 16. So all these options are completely editable. And since this text box is, you can edit this text box, so you could also say X orders in the last 30 days, or you can say that, these many orders were placed for Christmas, right? So you can make that more specific. And again, it's an open playground, and you can edit this and make this however you want it, right? Now let's move on to sales snippet. So sales snippet, let me show you on the WooCommerce product page. This is how it appears. So it actually shows you the name of the people and the city from where they have bought it, right? So it fetches the data from this backend of your store. So it crunches the data and then shows the relevant data on the page up front, right? So here again, you can set the date limit within people who bought it within 30 days or within 15 days or 3 months, or you can even custom write this, right? So you can change this data as per your requirement. Then it is the sales snippet text. So this is how it shows it. This is how it outputs the data. So buyer A from city A, buyer B from city B, and X others bought the item recently. Also, let's say if there have been 5 sales or 7 sales in the past 30 days, then it is not actually going to show the name of the city of all the buyers. It is going to smartly crunch the data and just say that, just show probably names and places of 2 buyers, and then it's going to say, and 5 others bought this item recently, right? So just to prevent the clutter, it's going to smartly show the data up front. Also, again, you have all these options. You can customize the background color, the border color, the text color, font size. As you can see right now, we have given it a bit of border and we've given it a bit of background color just so that it sets itself apart from the other things out here, from the other elements out here, right? The next thing is the rule builder, which is a very interesting feature in Sales Trigger. So what you can say is that I do not want the sales snippet or the sales count to appear on all my products, but I only want it on a certain category, or I only want it on a certain product type, or maybe just on products which are actually greater than say $50, right? And on product category you can actually enter the exact category, right? So it allows you to do all of that, to configure it, to customize it, and there are a lot of options. So I will just invite you to treat this like an open playground and come over and play.
If you like what you saw, well, I would encourage you to head out to excelplugins.com/WooCommerce Sales Triggers and look at these 7 psychological triggers that you can apply on your WooCommerce product page today and watch more orders pouring in. So it will allow you to display the countdown timer, to create urgency, show the stock status, then show the savings your shoppers can make in percentage and an absolute number, shows recent sales activity to again activate social proof, gives bulletproof guarantee box to show your commitment towards your store, towards your product, and to amp up their trust in your store. Then it actually reverts the reviews as satisfaction rate. So it says 92% buyers were satisfied with the product, or more than 86% of buyers gave us more than 4 stars, right? So statements like these, which completely change the way you look at reviews, instead of saying 3 reviews, 5 reviews, right? That doesn't really help anyone form an opinion. And then finally, it shows stores bestsellers to reduce anxiety and to direct people to the product that they want, right? So this is the before and after. So I hope, really hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, don't forget to head out to this link and go ahead and install this on your store right away.